Today I'm gonna show you a Apocheck deck. This deck don't use any legendary, only 3 epic cards. So it's really cheap and it's really useful. You can arrive to champion with this. I have seen a lot of these decks in champion. So it's not extremely difficult and it's extremely fast. And the key of this deck is the ultimate of Rathalos, Rat Awoken. That ultimate increased attack for every buff that you have used to buff the attack, plus the unit that get the ultimate when flight. So we'll use that with put shift attack to win. This card is the only epic that I'm using here, and I think this is really useful. If you don't have this, you can change that for extra buffs, but this card is really useful. Iris is extremely good in this type of decks. I'm gonna play a couple of games and I'm gonna show you how do you have to use this deck and what is the main strategy with this. I need to mention that I'm not playing ranked because this deck have an extremely counterable versus Morgana. Morgan will win almost 80% of the times when you fight with this deck. It's extremely difficult to win versus a Morgan deck with this type of deck. But versus green decks, it's almost 90% that you will win. And the main strategy here that you want to use with this deck is use all the pups that boost your attack as soon as you can. In the first turn you will use 10 in your monsters just to reduce the damage and trying to destroy the monster of the enemy. This is a really good strategy because you will make some damage and also destroy the early monster of the enemy. And eventually you will start to win a lot of attack with the ultimate. I'm ready to use 2 buffs, so I think that only one more and I will be able to win the game with the quick attack, with the rapid attack. It's a really good card that, and especially when you have the ultimate in one crit, because you will have flag, you will have combo, plus you will make crazy damage with this. So what are the units that you want to buff is the creatures that have combo. So you will buff the combo creatures with your ultimate. If you already lost a couple of them, you can buff any other unit that have a lot of attack. So I think that right now I can win. I only have to drop wheel and use the ultimate with quick attack and I already win. But I'm gonna destroy that Chun-Li, because it's really scary. That Chun-Li is a legendary card and have a lot of synergy with this deck. But we're trying to make a Apocheck deck, so that's why I didn't include that card in the deck. This Mega Man is thinking that he have a chance, but I'm really weird. I only have to use the ultimate. My combo creature, that's all. You see this 12 damage plus quick attack. It doesn't matter what they do with the green decks because they have a really high rate of loss versus this type of deck. So when you face Chun-Li or Mega Man, it's almost like 90% that you will win this fight. It's not a big deal. Hopefully in the next battle I'm gonna get something more challenging. Maybe someone with a better score. So let's play another one. Hopefully it will be maybe an A5 a champion. Something with this with a good score. Well, this look more challenging, it's A5 and he only need 2 victories more to become a champion. And it's really similar to the deck that my favorite deck, so I guess that I'm gonna win. As I told you before, the main strategy is use all the pups in the early turns. trying to reduce the damage is a really good option, especially when you're fighting versus flight units. I have this card that is Cell, and this is really useful versus flight units, combo units, units that increase the mana. It's extremely useful, that card, and it's really cheap. These two, and you will have a really good chance to win the game if you use them versus mana buffer versus flying units. I'm ready to make that crow just a piece of crap. And in the top, that monster is a little scary, but he lost 1 point of health every turn, so it's not a big deal. Now I'm gonna start to prepare everything from the ultimate. I think that he's gonna destroy my Carlos Olivera, my guy from Resident Evil. So I'm trying to save one, at least one, to use the ultimate. You have to be really careful with these decks because they have a lot of removals, so they can destroy my Carlos, any type of cards. Right now I can make crazy amount of damage. As I told you before, the removals are really scary. And this is the main counter of this deck. Destroy the monsters that you previously used your ultimate. It will reduce your probabilities of winning, but I already have a big advantage. Plus, I have another Critterwood combo, an Ares in the top, so I can have 13 points of health. Now just 7, and I'm ready to win this game. It doesn't matter what he do. And I need one quick attack, and I will win the game. I'm gonna use again. Oh, no, maybe Shulk. The Bison, I hate the Bison, it's not really useful in that type of decks, because if you didn't get him in the first turn, it's probably useless. Now I can use the ultimate. I'll use the ultimate in my combo critter and I will win the game. Maybe I will drop something in the middle lane just to reduce the damage. And I will use the ultimate and I will win the game as you see. This deck is really good because it's extremely fast. Now he'll have to destroy my monster in the bottom and cover the damage in the top. That is almost impossible, so he just surrender. And as you see, it's really good, this deck, if you want to win fast. I highly recommend this type of deck. But I need to mention that all the fights versus Morrigan will be extremely hard, and it's a really high probability that you will lose. And it doesn't matter what type of Morrigan decks you face, because all of them are a big threat for you. It's a really low probability that you will win. This will be an also really good fight, because this guy only need one victory more to become a champion. So I'm gonna use the same strategy, use both my monsters in the first turns and then use the ultimate and win. You want to get the combo critters as fast as you can, so that's why I'm using these critters to have a mana buff. They're not really useful, but they can make your deck really fast. You will get all the buffs really, really fast. As you can see here, I'm already using 2 buffs. I have one extra more in the hand. And I already have the combo, it's Carlos Olivera plus quick attack. Hissy. You want to use your combo critter with someone that is really weak. For example, that Doberman. That Doberman is a really good option to draw Carlos Olivera with the ultimate. And I'm gonna hold a couple of turns. I want at least one buff to use in my combo crypto, just to accelerate the win. To be completely sure that I will win without problems, because this type of deck have a lot of removals. And he make a serious mistake throwing that guy in the top, because he will eat that half of damage. Yeah, he just wastes 4 mana points with that. And I think that I'm gonna use my ultimate right now. Yeah, I'm gonna use the ultimate. We don't have enough mana to use the removal. 12 of damage. Now, another extra 12. And he used 5 mana points, so I'm ready to win this fight. Doesn't matter what he do. So I have my another combo critter and an extra pop, so yeah. So I told you before, what you really want to do is use the ultimate with quick attack. Or wait until he have 15 damage or something like that, and you will win immediately. But this is the main combo, quick attack with ultimate in any monster that have combo. I'm gonna show you again the cards. The main strategy is use all the buffs and their ultimate in your combo critters. If you want to copy this deck or improve that, here is the code. Now I'm gonna show you what cards will work better with this. These cards are legendary and really expensive. So I change one wheel for one Chun-Li, the legendary Chun-Li that have a quick attack. This one. It's a legendary card and it's really expensive to craft this, so you need to consider if you really want to use this deck, a green deck. And the other card that I really like with this deck is an epic card that make a lot of damage. So this card make damage proportionally to your HP points. So you can make a 7 or 5 points of damage just with 3 mana. If you like this deck, this video, please subscribe to my channel, leave a comment.